Hi, I'm Dr. Chuck Betters. Welcome to Ask Dr. Betters. This is where we try to take your questions and relate them to Holy Scripture. One of the things I want to encourage you to understand about this feature that we call Ask Dr. Betters is that some of the questions you ask simply cannot be answered in the few minutes that we have here on these videos. They need further help. And I want to encourage you to understand that right here at Mark Inc. Ministries, we have something called Anchored Hope Biblical Counseling. I want to encourage you, especially with this particular question, I want to encourage you to seek professional help, and we are offering biblical counseling as that professional help. You can go to biblical counseling, one word, biblicalcounseling.online. And you can make an appointment with one of our counselors. They are scattered all over the country. It is a virtual counseling center where they can come into the privacy of your home and you into the privacy of their virtual office and get the help you need. I want to encourage ahead of time this particular man who raises this question to seek that help. He says, "All my life, I have been attracted to the same sex. I'm going back to early childhood, elementary school age. I've heard we're born either straight or gay or bi. I've heard as a Christian that it's a sin. I believe it is. I have never acted upon this with another man, only in thought and through fleshly pleasures. I am saved and baptized. I believe in God, in Christ. I've accepted him as my creator and savior and Lord, but I'm torn between why I'm gay and why he has never taken it from me. I've prayed for it to be taken. I've tried giving up the thoughts and feelings of sexual desire toward men. It never goes away. I hate it. It has consumed my entire life in every way and has ruined my life since middle school. I need help. What am I doing wrong to get rid of it? Am I to live with it till I die, yet learn to not act or think on it? Please help, Dr. Betters. I'm at the point of giving up on God or dying now to have the peace I hear of that takes place in heaven." Well, my friend, you're not alone. In fact, we have a whole variety of resources of people just like you who go on the record to talk about exactly what they've been going through, which mirrors pretty much what you're going through. You know, we're all born with certain tendencies. There are innate qualities in all of us. Some have the anger gene, some have the depression gene, some have the alcohol dream, some have a sexual sort of gene that affects us all of our lives. I can go on and on and on with a list of things that affect us that we're born with. You know, like any tendency, whether it's a sexual sin or an emotional sin of some sort, we have to fight it. We have to put up our defenses. We have to plan. We have to have a strategy. I mean, for example, there are some people who are born with certain tendencies toward, say, anger. Children learn over the course of time how to deal wrongly with anger, but maybe the tendency is already there, or depression. We have to fight those. We have to battle those. We have to put strategies in place to overcome those. We cannot submit to those. Sounds like you're having a real war on handling sexual temptation, especially same-sex attraction. Others have been where you are. There are some who battle sexual temptation that is heterosexual, where they constantly are fighting the tendencies toward adultery or fornication or sexual sin of other kinds. We have to battle those. We have to battle those sins. We have to declare war and put biblical strategies in place. Now, our counselors can help you to do that. but our resources can also help you to understand that. I have one resource here at Mark Inc. Ministries where there are three men, all of whom struggle with sexual temptation, sexual attraction to other men. Two of those men are married to women, and they came out, quote unquote, on this resource that we offered. It was quite revealing, it was heartbreaking. I mean, I had so much respect for these men, their willingness to face off, to square off, to call it what it is sin. Just as heterosexual temptation can lead to sin, the temptation is not the sin. It's when we succumb to the temptation. And it sounds like you are resisting succumbing with everything you have inside of you. I'm glad to know you are a believer, but you can listen to these three men. You can hear their struggle. You can hear how they handle that struggle. We have other resources. We have a theological discussion with four pastors where we look at the scriptures and what they have to say. We also have an interview with Dr. Rosaria Butterfield, who gave her life to her own same-sex attraction and then found Christ and found the power to find forgiveness in Christ. She's now married to a Reformed minister. She has children. Her life has been turned around, yet she admits to the same struggles that continue to haunt her, even though she's married now, rightfully and biblically, to another man. Those resources will be incredibly helpful to you. But more importantly, I think you need some hands-on help. You need some opportunities to talk to trained biblical counselors who can help you walk through this whole temptation scheme. You know, I do believe there are some who are born with homosexual tendencies. I do believe that there are some who are born with heterosexual tendencies, all of which can become sinful. And as I said earlier, there are certain tendencies that all of us have that we have to struggle with. I hope you will continue your struggle. I hope you will realize that this will be a lifelong struggle for you, but you can find peace and you can find contentment in handling yourself sexually the right way, the biblical way. One man, one woman, one lifetime. Continue to fight, my brother. Continue to fight with everything you have, and God will reward that. I'm glad you wrote the question. I'm glad you had the guts to write the question. I commend you for your honesty. I commend you for your transparency. But I want to make sure you are going to get the right help that you need. So start with our resources. Listen to those. Take the time to absorb what is being said on a variety of resources you can find at markinc.org, markinc.org. Look at our Help and Hope library, and there you will find all those resources. Take some time to listen to them. Take some time to examine the scriptures that we speak of in them, and then get some help to overcome this horrible war that you're in. Now, having said that, I want to remind you of this. All of us struggle with certain life-dominating sins. All of us have tendencies that we battle every day of our lives. All of us struggle with things that we submit to, we fall into gross sin, and then we stand back and we hate ourselves for it. We look at ourselves and we say, why did I do that? Why did I submit to that? And we grieve over our sins. That's good, because that shows true, genuine desire to repent, to put off the old, to put on the new. Take some time into Colossians 3. Read what Paul has to say about putting off the old man, putting on the new man. And it's a daily struggle. Read Romans 7, where Paul has his double talk, talks about doing the right thing, ends up doing the wrong thing. He wants to do the right thing. He ends up doing the wrong thing. He goes back and forth. And he talks about the battle of the flesh. You're not the only one to have this battle. All of us do. All of us struggle. Your sin happens to be different than mine. But nonetheless, they are still struggles against the sin nature that indwells us. So spend some time in Romans 7. Spend some time in Colossians 3. Spend some time in our resources. Get some help. I want to encourage you. We're here to help you. Some of our counselors specialize in just this, and I hope you will take advantage of it. Thanks, brother, for writing. Thank you for your honesty. Thank you for your question. And I am praying that God will bless and encourage you. Stay in touch. I want to hear from you again. God bless.
Hi, my name is Melissa Weisenfels, Executive Director here at Mark Inc. Ministries. Thank you so very much for your continued support of this video series. Ask Dr. Betters is not meant to be a substitute for professional counseling, but instead is designed to extract biblical principles around the questions being asked. We encourage you to seek professional counseling if needed.